ready to order? What about today's special, Butcher's Revenge or Meatloaf? Now, I don't know how Meatloaf got that diner name, but since we're rocking the 50s diner vibe, why not roll our tongues in the lingo as well? So today, I'm making Butcher's Revenge burgers or Meatloaf burgers. It's the bomb for Bean Busters. So let's get started. The first thing we have to do is, of course, the burger patties or the meatloaf patties. So I've got here about 1/2 kilo of ground beef. Now, you're probably gonna be tempted to get all lean ground beef, but when you're making meatloaf or burgers, you want a good mix of fat and lean meat. So I've got here a nice mix, and I'm gonna add in some carrots and onions. So I'm gonna start with the carrots. I'm gonna grate some in. And actually, this is a really nice way to get your kids to eat veggies too. You can just hide it in the burger patties. Smart, eh? Okay, that should be good. And then some white onion. So we're gonna season this with some salt and pepper. So a little bit of salt to start. And black pepper. I'm gonna add in some steak sauce. Now, I'm not really a big steak sauce fan. I mean, when I have my steak, I'm a Worcestershire sauce kind of guy. But I promise you, if you add it in your burger, it's gonna taste really awesome. It's got that nice sour taste, and it's gonna make your burgers taste a little bit like steak. Huh? So just a couple of tablespoons, and it should be good. And then we're gonna mix it up. Okay, and then we're gonna add in our egg. That is gonna be the real binder of this dish. So the egg is the one that's going to bind everything together. The main difference between a burger and a meatloaf is the egg. For me, a real burger is basically just beef and maybe a little bit of onions, but that's it. And then you form them and they're gonna break off easily. But for meatloafs, you wanna add in breadcrumbs and egg, and when you mix them together, they're going to really come together, and you can even slice them. That's the difference between a meatloaf and a burger. It's really all about the egg. So we're just gonna mix this together. So after giving this a good mixing and mashing, what you wanna do is form one large patty, and then with your fingers, just cut it in half. That's about half there. And then you cut each half into fourths, and you can pretty much have 4 equal pieces. That's about 1/4 pound each. So I'm gonna set these guys aside, and then I'm gonna do the buns. So for these burgers, I want the buns toasted. And then we're just gonna put them straight onto our grill. Okay, I'm gonna let these guys go. I'm gonna grab myself a bowl and we're gonna prepare a special dressing. Okay, so I've got my bowl here. We're just gonna turn the bread over. So these guys are gonna be ready in a minute. So let me grab a plate. And now we're gonna go with our burgers. And again, nice hot grill. We're gonna form our burgers. And they're gonna be pretty much easier to handle since we put in the egg and the breadcrumbs. So you can pretty much shape it the way you like it and just put it on the grill. All right, so we'll let our burgers grill for about 2 minutes on each side, and then we can finish it in the oven just to make sure it's fully cooked. But in the meantime, we're gonna prepare that special dressing I was talking about. So of course, when you've got burgers, you've gotta top ketchup, right? We wanna paint it red, as they say. So this is just tomato ketchup. You can use your favorite kind. Just pour that in. And then to this, we're gonna add in some horseradish. So horseradish gives you a really nice spicy taste, and it's gonna put a real zing onto our burgers. So a couple of heaping teaspoons there. And then just a little bit of citrus with calamansi. Just a little bit of a squeeze. And it's really gonna bring out a lot of that flavors of the horseradish and the ketchup. So let's just mix this in. Nice. So if you don't like it super spicy, you can lessen the amount of horseradish, or you can add a little bit more ketchup. But I like it spicy. Okay, so our dressing is done. I'm gonna give this a quick taste. Wow, that has a lot of kick in it. That's gonna be great for our burgers. Okay, speaking of the burgers, let's flip them. So the burgers are gonna be ready in a couple of minutes, and then we're gonna add in some rabbit food, which is also known as lettuce, some love apples or tomatoes, and then of course some dill pickles. And then we're gonna assemble the burger together with our special sauce. It's gonna be great. Oh, this burger is just awesome. I mean, the burger patty is really meaty and juicy, and then you've got that really zesty flavor from the pickles and of course that special sauce. It's a great combination all around. I mean, they say that revenge is a dish best served cold, but believe me, butcher's revenge is best served hot, hot, hot.